lovely people, you are welcome to my channel. Thanks so much for your support. Thanks for being part of this channel. If you have not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing and do well to share this video. You might win a soul by sharing this video. We are in lesson 2 of our new quarter, and the lesson 2, the title is Crisis of Leadership. Crisis of Leadership. I'm here to give you a summary of the Sabbath afternoon, Sunday and Monday lessons. Our key text is taken from Isaiah 6 verse 1, and I read, "In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple." Amen. The introduction of the lesson is a story concerning Confucius and his disciples. And his disciples asked him what makes a good governance. And Confucius replied that sufficient food, sufficient weapon, and confidence or trust of the people. Then the disciple asked him again, "If you are asked to take one from it, which one will you take out?" And he said, "More weapon or sufficient weapon." Then the disciple asked again, "In case you are forced to take one out of the two, which one will you put away?" And he said, "Food." And his reason being that if people do not have trust in their leadership, then they are lost. So it tells that if you are a leader and the people you are ruling don't trust in your ruling or your leadership, then it means you cannot rule them. And so the whole of the week we are going to look at crisis of leadership in the time of the Israelites and how God came in to save his people, or how God revealed himself to his people. We are moving straight to Sunday, and the Sunday is titled "The King is Dead, Long Live the King." The King is Dead, Long Live the King. The Sunday lesson is based on 2 Chronicles 26, where Uzziah started as a king or became a king at a tender age, at the age of 16, and he did so well, went to war, a lot of success and all that. And so at a point in his life, Uzziah thought, oh, where he has gotten to, he is equal with God. Pride entered in, and so he started taking up responsibilities that are not meant for him, responsibilities that are meant for the priests. He went into the temple to burn incense, thinking that doing that is going to get him more and more closer to God. Meanwhile, that duty is supposed to be performed by the priest. The priest approached him to warn him against that, but he got angry. And as a result of that, God allowed leprosy to strike him. And so the question is, what is the significance of the king Uzziah's death? That is the question the lesson is asking us. And the lesson gave us some points that we are going to consider. The first point is that he says that Uzziah, it is as a result of his stubbornness or pride that got him into that state. That God, when he was warned, he refused what, to listen. And as a result of that, God allowed leprosy to come upon him. At that very moment, he was separated from his people and he died. When he died, at that very moment too, that was the time God revealed himself to Isaiah. That was the time Isaiah saw God's holiness. And so one will say that, oh, because of what the king did, it has brought some kind of curse or God's anger on his people, so God will not reveal himself to his people. But God still revealed himself to Isaiah. There is a striking contrast between Uzziah and Isaiah. Uzziah reached for holiness presumptuously for the wrong reason, and instead became ritually impure so that he was cut off from holiness. Isaiah, on the other hand, allowed God's holiness to reach him. Amen. And so the second point is that Isaiah, for him, he humbled himself for God to reach him with his holiness. But Uzziah, in his case, he decided to take up the responsibility to become holy by himself, forgetting that holiness depends on God and God alone. There is a striking similarity between Uzziah's leprous body and the moral condition of his people. There is no soundness in it, but bruises and sores and bleeding wounds. And so what happened to Uzziah can be compared to his people, their moral condition or their moral state. And the fourth lesson, or the fourth point, is also that in the history of Israel, the king is the one who leads them to war and all that. So if your king is dead, then it means you are on your way to failure. At that time that the king died, that was the time that there were attackers here and there. And so Israel was afraid. Now the king who is supposed to lead them to war It's no more. And so it's like there is no hope. But that was the time God revealed himself to Isaiah to make him know that he is still in control. And so God is always in control and will always be in control. No matter the situation we find ourselves in, God is in control. We are moving straight to Monday. The Monday lesson is titled Holy, Holy, Holy. Holy, Holy, Holy. And the Monday lesson is based on Isaiah 6 verses 1 to 4. The Monday lesson is given to us that at the time King Uzziah died, it was like there is no hope and there was despair everywhere. But God revealed himself to Isaiah. And Isaiah in vision saw angels bowing to God and singing Holy, Holy, Holy. When there was fear and people thought that God's anger is on the nation, that was the time God revealed his holiness to his people. The lesson is given to us that Isaiah at that point needed special encouragement, comfort from God to know that God is in control. God has not left them. God is still with his people. The transcendent holiness of God emphasized in Isaiah's vision is a basic aspect of his message. God is a holy God and he demands holiness from his people. A holiness he will give to them if only they would repent, turn from their evil ways and submit to him in faith and in obedience. Amen. And so the vision God gave to Isaiah shows how holy God is and that we cannot take his holiness for granted. And what he demands from us is holiness and obedience. And that can be given to us only through God. All of us have been in discouraging situations where from outward appearance all seemed lost. Even if you didn't get a vision of the glory of the Lord, as did Isaiah, recount the ways in which the Lord was able to sustain you and your faith during this crisis. What have you learned from these experiences that you could share with others? So all of us have been in situations where we thought, oh, God has left us, there is no hope and all about. God in his own way comforted us and encouraged us. Thanks so much for being part of today's summary. If you have not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing, like and share the video. Bye-bye.